Well, fancy meeting you here. Long time no see. I have not posted a vlog on this channel for quite some time now, and it's not through lack of trying. I do have at least 3 hours of footage that I've filmed in the last year or so that I have never edited and never uploaded. But I'd like to get back into it. I miss vlogging, I miss documenting my life, especially now that, as you may have seen, we have a new addition to our family. Koo is obviously getting older. He's always been a super playful pup, and I always knew it'd be really nice to get him a friend. So meet Kai, the Siberian kitten. He is 4.5 months old. He's just been neutered. He eats raw currently. We're switching him to cooked. None of this really matters, but to say that he is the perfect addition to our family. He currently acts very dog-like. He likes playing with Koo. They like tackling each other on the ground. Seems like Kai is catching up in size to Koo as well, so I think they're going to be a nice match as soon as Kai gets a bit older. Koo himself has changed a bit since I last vlogged. When I last vlogged, he was like a tiny little puppy, and now he is 2 years old, turns 3 in March, and he is a big, gigantic monster, but also very cute. One other not just notable but gigantic change since our last video: we've left London. We don't live in the city anymore. We live in a smaller town. I mean, it still feels like a city to me, having grown up in small town New Zealand, but we live in a much smaller town by the seaside. We have a lovely 3-bedroom bungalow with a massive backyard, lots and lots of space for Koo and Kai to be playing around. And generally, we just live a bit of a quieter life at the moment. It's not entirely intentional. Playing video games all day is nice and that, but it kind of is that settling in period to a new place, even though it's been 9 months now since I moved, where I'm still trying to find my people. I'm still trying to find my activities here. The good thing is it's a super dog-friendly area. So every day, Koo and I are out there walking different walks in the woods, on the seaside, over the fields, whatever we feel like on any particular day. We are so incredibly lucky with this area. And I can tell how much happier Koo is. I can also tell how much happier every other dog we meet is. I never had anything against apartment living with a dog. I think it trained Koo to be really well behaved, but also I can just see how he loves spending 24/7 outdoors in the green area, you know, just living his best life, and that makes me really happy about the move. But we still have a lot of human settling in to do in terms of finding me some friends. The whole reason I was able to actually move out of the city and get into the countryside-ish is thanks to my job. I now have a 100% remote job. It's, you know, it pays the bills. It is rather stressful. It's a new company, it's a new world, a different way of doing things, and I am still adjusting. I changed jobs at the end of last year, so I'm coming up on 1 year anniversary at this job. And I am, despite everything, incredibly grateful to be able to be at home, to be able to look after Koo and Kai 24/7, to have a cat who lays across my keyboard and deletes all of my emails that I've carefully constructed. I don't know if I could ever go back to working in an office again, I have to say. Even just having to leave Koo for half days back in London was heartbreaking. So, in terms of work-life balance, we are a whole lot happier now. As I alluded to, Ku has changed a bit more. I mean, he's over two now, so he's becoming an adult, so they say. I'm not so sure about that. He's still a bit of a monster puppy, but he certainly has calmed down by way of overexcitement, inability to settle, all of those challenges that we had in the first year or so of his life. It was hard. Puppies are hard, okay? And Ku was an incredibly difficult puppy, having met other puppies now and other people who have had puppies. Ku must have been a challenging case because he was tricky. But now he's just my best friend. He truly is so in sync with me, almost too in sync, because when I'm grumpy, he's grumpy. But he's my best buddy, and I love seeing him grow older, although please don't grow too old.
Raining.
We did move into an entirely unfurnished flat, so there was a lot of furniture purchasing that had to happen. In the midst of all of that, we also kind of outgrew some of our stuff. This here is the first ever big furniture purchase I ever made. It's a chaise lounge. At the time, it felt like it cost me my entire savings. I think it was about 700, £800, which is expensive. I'm not sure if it was worth it, but honestly, I did tear up having to sell it this day. I decided that it didn't really fit in our space anymore, and so it was time to say goodbye to it. And even with the chewed legs and the stains and things, someone still wanted to purchase it, so I'm pretty proud of that. But I will be sad to see it go. One of the best things about having a gigantic backyard is the amount of activities we can do in it. So much room for activities. One of my favorite activities this summer, despite the weather, has been the paddling pool. We got it when we had a foster dog. Oh yeah, by the way, we've had foster dogs this year too. We got this paddling pool for Ku and the foster dog to play in, but the foster dog refused to go in, and Ku took a lot of coaxing. He's still kind of learning to get his confidence in there, but he's come a long way since I first whipped out the paddling pool and since we first started going to all the streams and swimming spots around here. He will now go in reluctantly, but he will go in. I have come out a couple of times and found that he's gone in by himself, but mostly he waits for me to throw treats in first, and then kaplop, he will pop in. He's so cute. I really want to build his confidence in water since we live by the sea and we have lots of swimming spots around here. So next month we're actually booked in to go to the pool. Maybe I'll vlog it. I leave no promises. We all know my track record the past couple of years. I'd really like to teach him how to swim, or at least show him that he can swim, because I'm fairly certain he'll be able to if he's put in deep enough water. He just has a bit of trouble getting into the deep water. And then once he learns how to swim, the next challenge will be getting him to brave the waves. He's currently a little bit scared of the noise of the waves, which is, fair enough. He's never experienced that before. The only water that we've been near for his first 2 years of life was the Thames, which is water that I didn't necessarily want him going in anyway. So I think it's fine that he builds confidence in cleaner water. Ku does spend most of his time outside. Some nights I have to actually drag him in because he wants to be outside. I'm fairly certain he would sleep out there with the foxes if he could. Anytime I come outside to check on him or play with him, he is so happy that I'm out there. Little does he know I'm not necessarily, a bugs and outdoor kind of person, but I'm very happy for him that he has the space. I'm also very sad that we're coming to the end of summer. Granted, it hasn't been the best summer, meaning that I am going to have to drag him in more often. Even today, when I'm recording this voiceover, it is raining outside and I had to bring him inside, and he is currently lying next to the back door waiting for me to open it again for him. So you can tell how much of an outdoor lover he is. While I'm sad about summer ending, I am also kind of excited for the cooler weather and also for the quieter walks with Koo. Hopefully this time I'll remember to bring you with us.
Dude.